Okay, welcome back to part 3 of my Let's Play of Saga 2, the remake on the 3DS, on the DS, not the 3DS. We left off earlier, and I'm making a bunch of mistakes, usually with the volume control of what I'm doing, and the game I'm playing, and right now I am... Hey, hello. I actually was playing for a little bit, and then I realized, oh, I screwed up my volume control again, thanks to some people in the chat, and I'm not gonna leave that like that, because that just sounds completely horrible. Is my voice coming through better now? I think it's coming through. I hope it's coming through. If there's a problem, please let me know. Oh, about time she learns a different ability. Alright, so anyway, then what happened in the last video is I was in the town, right before I ended the last video, I was stuck in the town of the Muses, and I gave two of the items to Calliope and one of them to Etoile, and she yelled Oitsu at me, well, O-H-U, but it looks like Oitsu. And I apologize, I got the one item wrong, the one that's the cotton candy goes to Calliope, not to Polly. That was literally it. We came here, there were three excavation points, and that's it. Alright, so anyway, then we came over here, and then there was a quest here that said, oh, there's some treasure in the Giants area, and I'm like, okay, cool. And that was it. That was the extent of my gaming between, between the two videos. So, I apologize that this isn't a full 100% Let's Play, but I think those are skippable. Those parts aren't really 100% necessary. I did also mention that the Giants in Curious over here is extremely good. So, let me go ahead and pick that up here. It's very overpriced, but... That's some of the best stuff in the game. Oh, no worries. Thank you for stopping by. Yeah, actually around 6 or 7, I wanted to start doing the Jackbox stream. It's just that we had a really horrible turnout earlier. We had a couple of people, but... We had so many people just leaving the games partway in, and it was kind of hard to really play with just really two and three people participating. Oh, you know what, I'm gonna go drop off the... That's all I really did last time, was the whole thing with the Muses. I'd love to show you the Muses, sort of. I think they're all named after Greek nymphs, I could have sworn. Yeah, in order to actually get here, you actually have to talk to Johnny and... Oh, you have to go to the... I have to go to the back first, then I go talk to Johnny, that's right. Then... One of the muses, I forget what her name is, she's the muse of the insects, comes by. This part's still the same from the other game. Actually, Sawyer, how good are you with your Greek mythology? Do you know anything about them? Do you know anything about the muses from the from that? So I used to be a Latin buff long, long ago. Like, it's like about 20 years. I've been out of high school for about 20 years now, so I don't remember too much about Latin. This is World 3. So I'll show you the next the insect guys is coming up here. Might as well just make real quick. I think they put an undead status here. I think that's what the cross is for. So I talk to Johnny, I'll show you the cutscene with the butterfly and the insect muse. Oh, here's one of the muses right here. She's a musical muse. I can't remember her name. But how she works, she joins your group whenever you, well, not group, but she joins the muses whenever you hear all of her tunes. No, it's not available on SaGa. This is actually a fan translation because, once again, they don't want to bring over a awesome game. But the guys over at Nocturnal. Crimson Nocturnal. They did a translation for this. Hang on a second. I thought I sent you this ROM before. One second. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's not worth, I don't think it's worth getting the game, figuring out how to run a translation patch on it, and then loading it into a DS. It's probably better to just play the end ROM. Oh, absolutely, this game's amazing. Oh, this is the insect muse. Now, when you play it, I recommend, I'm going to give you a couple of settings to use. I'll explain how you do it. I mean, I'll send you a little link. It'll have a set some settings for the volume controls. No, Thalia is the insect muse. It's just kind of funny how the only one who got corrupted by the, in this game I've seen from the muses, is the insect one. Because all the other muses are, they all are to themselves. So once you turn to an insect, you go over here and grab yourself some fairy candies. And you gotta bring the fairy. This is just a quick fetch quest. I mean, I'm tit for tat on this one. I actually do like the addition of the quests. I don't. This one just seems kind of a little bit it just seems too close range fetch quests. Oh, I need to go give the, wait, I need the bottle to give it to somebody who can do, there it is. Most of the side quests aren't this quick. This one just for some reason is internal. Don't get any more tweets. Let's see. Let's go back and get Thalia out. Yeah, it's a fun game. You'd love it, Swear. Set up the town. Wait, how much more do you need? This part of the game has a good bit of stuff. Let me try and don't bring too much. Where's the crossbows? Oh, cursed. Turns off curses. Okay. Just drop some stuff at the sell it. To the Giant's town. I'm trying to remember all the goddesses. There's a centaur goddess, the battle goddess, there's the robot goddess, Mecha, whatever, the Twi'el, Calliope, the wind goddess, Pollyanna, and Mel, the sisters, the friends, I don't remember. Melmoné, that's her name, Melmoné. Yeah, also, Swerve, I know you always talk to me a lot about the Morale stuff. One of the way you do combo attacks is by using this special thing called the Morale thread. And that changes your party's attitude towards each other based on which ones they use. Fix that. I want to keep acid rain on Lindsay. Let's get rid of their sleep. Even though I kind of wanted to keep it, but man. He can change into different monsters based on what meets me. I was showing it the other day, I'll show it to you real quick. I saved my game from the, I did a New Game Plus, so I was able to keep my old dictionary of creatures. So the monster actually turns into various creatures, including a kitty girl, a cat girl, Anubis, random goblins, frogs, crabs, turtles, various lions and such, griffins, manticores, oh, swords. I thought the guy Bull got missing. Scarabs, golems, bee woman. Tigers, dragons, Seiryu, harpies and Nikes, late Lamias, fairies. Fairies are still my favorite of the race in the game, just because endgame they are amazing. Yeah, and the way that they adjusted the game is actually something I had screwed up on. I had said that the monsters were of a support class because they really didn't have much to them or much power because they were kind of low HP and damage. But I found out that equipping a power-up item on so they do more damage actually, instead of giving it to a human, actually was the way to go. And they actually they're actually competent now. Because originally I thought they were kind of just for hard mode, because you really couldn't do much with them. Oh, you missed it. Yesterday also we had the dragon and gave everybody after him the ability to breathe fire after I kept fusing the dragon to something other people. It's very in-depth. The monster system game is actually pretty big. They haven't added any more monsters. They added a couple of special ones specifically for the arena, the bonus dungeons, which I would love to actually play. I just can't. Literally, yesterday I got another friend of mine to actually try this game out. There is a multiplayer arena mode too for co-op. I've been dying to play it, but I don't know how to actually get these games to if there's a way to get emulators to link up properly. But I would love to actually do the arena to get multiplayer. Oh, also that's not all the creatures. That's just the ones that you can fuse into. It doesn't count the pretty much anybody human, anybody a robot, or any bosses. With the exception of the four Genbu, Seiryu, Suzaku, and Byakko. So what we're doing over here, we're grabbing the ability to go smaller so we can go inside of the cute cleric's body, because she's got a sort of Lord Ashura's minions in her. cars. I never thought about disarming that trap in here. It's already been released, so. Big group to increase the reward. Acid rain powers up. No, just acid rain. Change. I remember seeing another one for acid rain. Finding some of the creatures are robots on an overworld where I haven't actually seen them. I do know they are in this area. Oh, so anyway, for yesterday, I had an interesting thing I was talking about, and I if you watched it, I was going to say this to the people watching this, if you have watched the one from yesterday, I'm going to repeat myself, but I thought it was really funny. The only weapon degrading, it's the same as a weapon degrading system, and the only thing I never could figure out is how taijutsu, basically your kung fu of the game, how it has a limited number of uses. I even said it makes sense if it would be something like you have a scroll or brass knuckles or something that makes your attacks powerful. But the way they pull it off in this game is it literally feels like after you punch somebody or kick somebody 80 times, you forget where your foot's at. And also for some reason I was highly amused yesterday by the mecha being able to do kung fu also. shot. Yeah, it is pretty bizarre. Because in the original, in Legend 2 for the Game Boy, it went punch kick, headbutt, X kick, counter, somewhere in there, judo, and karate. So in this one, I know the last one's called Hell Wheel, I forget what they call judo. Side and get my bird here some meat so he doesn't just flap around like an idiot all day. Yes, finally. Anything's better when you're already at, buddy. He just healed. killed again. Stupid bird. So my party is distrustful of me. That's not good. Oh, that's right. I have a whole load of kicks. everybody's threads so that they're not all hateful towards each other. Now we're gonna go back, let's go back and help Kai. Do one more shot and see if I get that bird's meat. Yeah, now he's in. Now he's in information. Since it's a long road back, I'm just gonna just fast forward this. Alright, just fast forward the battles over here since they're just literal weak enemies over here. Quest. I think all this does is open the treasure spot. Yeah, this is another thing too. Apparently the townspeople are very inept at figuring out and hearing news about when a base gets destroyed. Yeah, I need to get my team, my party fixed, they're all pissed off each other. But there are, this next dungeon is Kai's body. There are absolutely no treasure chests, but let me drop something. Oh, that's nice. Okay, the bird got worse. And it's been a while since I saved, so I'm gonna head and save at the ferry here. Just real quick, I do want to do a quick check and see if anybody's still willing to play some Jackbox in a little bit. If not, I'm gonna keep going with this. this dungeon is the reason why this game kind of lags a little to me. This dungeon is not huge, it's kind of large. It's also in the shape of a person's body, it's Kai's mouth, and we have to go through her bloodstream now. Alright, we have to go both arms, both legs, stomach, heart, and I think the intestines. Or is it just stomach and heart? I forget. The heart also goes into different parts of the body. The heart has little holes that can teleport you. Like a bloodstream, that was added in to this game. Oh, another thing too is freaking this darn map. Okay, there's our target. Please become something. Sometimes the monster is a lot of fun in this game. I want to say right here. And sometimes just. Mr. Pebble, please just give him a slow golf clap. Thank you. The influenza virus to be a smiley face. Please, I'm begging you. Thank you. Also, this dungeon is nice because each time you grab one of the parts of the relics, it teleports you back out of that part of the body, which is pretty convenient, because some of these get really long, like the intestine. Unfortunately, the one for the heart is feral. The teleporter at the heart is somewhat useless, only because right after you grab the relic, you're teleported back out, and you have to go back in. So effectiveness is kind of questionable. Also, I would say it's a little bit better in this version than the Game Boy version, because this one you can just continually just dodge the enemies, as long as you'll get one of the ones that chases you at a fast rate. because it does get a little warm for a while in here. I'm just gonna start, use some of my, use those shields. That's a good use for it too. And all it generally does, to the best of my knowledge, is it's the old turn counter. Increased defense. Yes, that's actually one of the good side effects from using a shield. Permanent defense upgrade. I actually heard a rumor that the espers slash mutants are better than the humans for obtaining defense that way. I'm going to go to Kai's heart after I decide to just initiate a battle here. Blizzard turns into the SaGa. Okay, just a quick show of hands. Who's all here right now? Say there's nobody here, but I see people typing. Oh, I got a silencer. Yeah, it's a anti-aggro unit. I'm not gonna use that though, because my robot is somewhat tanky. There actually is is the opposite unit too, I just forget what it's called. Assume the silence is probably better at the end of the game, whenever the robot can die a lot quicker. Esper class change to attack. That is another thing too. When the Esper's abilities reach a certain set possible, they can change. I don't know how to explain. It's kind of like a sub Esper class. It's an invisible stat though. You can't really see what it is.
our horses change into a wood golem. Ah, crap. And it can't get any worse. For the most part of the game, though, the Esper would be an attack type anyway, because most of the abilities you get are attack. There's very, very few things that aren't, besides the automatic, resistant to fire, resistant to poison, etc. And cure. And I think counter also. Esper is a little bit limited on what they can become. I'm pretty sure there is a way of doing it, though, but I just don't know how. There are kind of a lack of buffing abilities in the game. I guess sleep, that's another thing too. Sleep. There's no stun spell. Well, there's no stun spell, there's just sidelong glance. Which is, I don't really get why that's a magic spell, to be honest with you. Alright, fast forward this one so we can frame 10 easier. Acid Rain is going to get a little bit useless later on, because it's a poison ability, and and most enemies become resistant to poison after a certain point in the game, so it's, and in here, especially because it's a body technically, it's fairly pointless. Oh, there's those holes that teleport to other parts of the body. Like I said, not overly useful. I mean, maybe one of them teleports you, maybe for a speed run, one can teleport you a slight bit closer to where you're going, but I didn't really sit here and want to mess around with that, so. Okay, get the intestine, I have to go all the way around, or is this this goes to the legs, the intestine's in the path. Cure. strife, friends, love. Strife, lovers, strife. Friends, lovers, hate. Let's organize a little bit more. Let's do family, love. There's one of the exit points for the heart. Randomized location of all of the relics. Nope. It's in the big toe. I really can't stand when games make you like a game where sleep doesn't wake you up after you get a hit. At least without not a good reason. I keep using that name to save it. Also might be thinking, oh, I'm not very good at this game. No, I'm actually decent. It's just the fact that you gotta think that half the time you play an RPG is based on stats. So I might not be the most efficient person playing it. I just play however. I mean, it's not like it's an action game where I can say, oh, I'm really good at it. I mean, I could sit here all day farming until I had 99 of all stats and 255 technically. Just go ahead and start playing, but nah, I'm not that needing of easy kind through this game. I appreciate this game having a little bit of difficulty. even though some parts do get a little long. Up to the stomach and into the leg. Funny thing is, I actually do enjoy doing this let's play, even though there's someone actively watching the main part of this live. Maybe somebody will enjoy it for what it's worth later on. I'll go get some later. Just barely stand. But I'll get it later. We need the other foot. I think actually influenza is weak to fire. If I know that. First. And stupid, 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 what is gone now? Yeah, it's decently long here, but it's not as long as it used to be. There's actually an excavation point here. I'll be damned. I think I didn't remember here before. I just never remembered it was here. Like, well, until I saw it. Agility source. Still a good one. Let me see what we got here. Agility's 10. Yeah, that's going to Lindsay. Source, since the defense stat is actually bitching rays on my own. This is the point of return. In the original game, there was no other treasure or anything, just you get all the relics and you get out. Thank you. excuse me. Sorry. I didn't catch it in time. Okay, there is no relic spot in your head, so we'll just head to the boss and get out of here. Trap disarming finally acquired. I remember part of the original story saying that the magi and relics were making her sick. So removing them actually saved her originally. Okay, if I remember correctly, this is she's a member of the goddesses. I wanted to see if they had another treasure spot. Yeah. Way too powerful for the area, it wouldn't even advance it. Strawberry pin badge. That one's for Polly. I know that one for a fact. Let's once again speed through this, because I don't want this whole thing. I did see a couple stat points of growth in there, so this is definitely worth coming to. Jump Z. That's a given. That's a quest item for later. So we're going to advance to the next area. These are no monsters. Second side quest, I would say. Yep, here he is. Excuse me. Yeah, the man with a funny face from the first town, if you were with me yesterday, you would have seen the guy who looks just like your father. And he just came back. They decided to give him a point. I do respect them for that. Thank you. Skirmish Drang. Correctly, the black box is a gift item for one of the muses. Or is it a FFL2 item of some sort? Yep, it is. Death Sword. I forgot the things I need that are on. Death Sword, I think. I forget if it's magic based or not. No, it's strength based. I can give it to the robot. Giants World real quick, and then I'll take a 2-minute break. And I'll see if anybody wants to do some Jackbox. If yes, then we'll do Jackbox. If not, I'll go ahead and do part 4. Sell some crap, no need. Silencer. That. Don't get long sword. Keep the lint if you use the first one. It's. I want the giant's armor. It's good. It's defensive, but. Yeah, let's keep it. I'm giving it to her just for the defense boost. I know she hasn't used any strength items, but that defense is gonna be where she can take a hit now. Oh, when I'm thinking about it, I'll sell off the other helmet I have there. Gloves, I mean. If I find a good enough armor, I'll give it to her, and I'll give my main character the giant armor then. So let's go ahead over here. I know I probably shouldn't be hitting that fast forward button so much, I apologize. That unlock the next goddess. Okay, the other one's not unlocked either. The only thing that one left does reset your team back to childhood friends, so it's fairly. This one's a little backwards. I think they probably did it on purpose just so it would look correct. This is the right way. Alright, so I'm gonna head and pause here. I'm gonna take a 2-minute break. Might have to go clip also to start this video. See if you want to do Jackbox. If not, we'll continue. I'll be back here in a few minutes.